we go. Sonic versus Lucina for game one. Understandably not wanting to go with Younger. Sonic isn't exactly going to be a viable strategy. Spring to cover the upbeat. And that's Hugless upbeat too early under pressure from Spring. This seems to be cracked in this game. Oh, look at the Krakus's foot clips her in the last frames of counter. Krakus needs some extra credit here. If he gets F smash now, all his work's gonna. Just as much Pug Ruby wants to be not get extra credit. How many of his name yet? Oh. He really double spot dodges on the platform. What players have any to make that? Practices. I'm gonna assume craft is checking out really well. And Lucina pretty much already evens it up. Already takes the lead back. You really want to be able to get some more extra credit this time, dude. Maybe we'll start a quick combo. But it's an F smash we're trying to approach again. Both players kind of eat through each other's defenses, but Krakus is getting what he wants out of each. Pug reads the hard spin deck, a hard homing attack, and smashes him through it. Where Krakus seems to control now, Pug seems to be an asset to invest in. Ooh, I was able to get the shield break! We've seen Krakus go for homing attacks all game with the picture of shield. We saw it against Frosty earlier on. He's able to really bring that back in. Punish Pugwest, but maybe you can just stay in shield. Krakus is having to pull pretty much all the stops. And Pugs, I mean, it just. Just as Wiz is able to come back and take what he saw. That is pretty hard off the center, but he stops doing that. I'm not able to continue doing that, so he's a really cool inside. That is a different pick-up. He's probably recovering, but he'll sink us back. Oh, he's trying to keep. But we've seen Krakus struggle with killing him. He is a hero side for a reason. It'll be important to see what he can do. Both players are they're fighting soccer and fighting game one. It is a best of three, so this should not be a good one. What is bigger? A falchion, a legendary sword, or one big fist from Sonic the Hedgehog taking game one? So I don't think they're actually listening to this. Are there like five people here right now? Like, you're up on Monday night, it was in the top. Thanks. appreciate it. Don't know if you're still really listening. Listening to Crap, the sweet sound of Crap is getting 3-4 years old. Let me see. And his grandpa. Back on PS2. This is really how this is going to play. Pretty good for that. One loss in momentum is just a huge swings. Crap's trying to get to the new edge. He just attacks and hunts ready for it. Both flashes in the other way. Let's see if Hulk can adapt to play Crap as he's gonna keep in control of the match. Able to mix up his recovery enough. Punishing Hug? He doesn't really get big punish for that. This deck of Hug. Ooh. Not really punk, but he swings it back. Power of ball jumps and air dodges. Even if most of Ultimate's on the video saves list is on a series without like easy to ball jump ball list. Do not forget the power of the ball. Also, do not forget the power of using his up tilt. Come on! At this point, Crackers struggle with killing. He's always been able to make it through again, but he's a different guy. He's a big opponent now. Technically, that's really more of Sonic than Craft is. Just not enough distance from that air dodge. We're going to be seeing a 3-1 stock setup, which may soon become a 2-1 stock setup. Craft is able to get that kill. But will it be enough? Does it compete? Pug already getting a ton of extra credit for this stock. Pug abusing the spring if even gives him a bunch of counters. It's a three counters. But, Pug West is a sword. Pug West dominates game 2 with 2 stocks and 50%.
I won!
Stealing momentum from Kraftus. We're gonna have to see what he can do to catch back up. This goes to another set, I may not have time to continue commentary, so... Yeah, I'm probably gonna end commentary after this set. If there is a set 2 of Grands, then unfortunately, I will not be able to finish commentary again. I unfortunately have a 30 minute drive home. I feel like that's the best. I mean, you got to play Crafters. You can help. You live and learn. Sonic knows live and learn. Crafters fails to tech that, and it's probably going to be bad for it. Except, no, it's not. Hugless does not have time. That's abusing wedges and Sonic. Abusing Sonic. Abusing all the good parts of Sonic. Including the spoiler system. This game between the two is not. Hugless able to down here, but. Hugless smashes to his Hugless with a cute. Almost takes Kraftus a stock at 100%. Kraftus needs to make something happen. Sonic is an unfortunate candidate in this game. Leads to a robot level or a crossover level. Takes the pump once. maybe I guess I put her in the end of the Raptus. Raptus is all the way down there. That's a homing attack, but Pokemon just moves out of the way and there's nothing to home on to except for that blast zone. Patch Smash Full Sign, but without all of the good parts, as our back row goes, but she is, seen as one Dolphin Slash away from being Sonic. Can Crack just come out? He will be tight. Side B, another one of those up here too. It's the homing attack, it's a move from the pressure, it gets up there, able to forward air. Back air comes out after spring. All of that Evercraft gets in.
The future is not written.
I don't know if it was bug this, but I could hear a no. It's an obvious spring, you know it. Coming from bug blast. Craft is on this all for you, but Ultimate Sonic, that might be there. I will read it, and if there is a set 2, I am going to read it. Pugless is not on the board game 5. Honestly, I feel that on one hand, but on the other hand, I kind of just want to end the set, because I kind of want to, see it to the end. But I also feel like that's a bit greedy, and it's probably just not going to be greedy. Seems to be off to an early lead, but we've seen this go wrong. I was getting audibly frustrated. I'm really trying to sound professional about this, it's just funny. This scene is to label the color issues. This scene, which is more expensive. Funny he's getting frustrated. Sonic is a character that can pretty easily take you off, but I think he's far more bearable than he is. He's gonna grab, but he keeps holding shield and gets grabbed. Breaks down on Bug, but gets the spring ride! And Kraftus is up 31! Bug really feels like he hasn't. Bug pretty clearly frustrated at this point. It'd be interesting to see. Up until this point, it seems like he had this on tap. Like he was all but in control of the entire game. Well, Sonic's early lead really got to him. Maybe some bad art teams, but seems to be getting back on track here. Trades for Citifolia, but we've seen Citifolia always get traded. What do we want this with Kraftus stop? Bug was trying to counter, and Kraftus can't do anything about it. Big Yoshi's platform. Too big? Kraftus with the up and go back smash! He does not enough to kill! Just keep this man as game 4. It's all but 1 at this point. We're gonna have to see some major changes from Pog here. Krappus seems ready for just about everything he's thrown at him. We don't even know the percent lead that Sonic has. If you can get a stock, this game looks real approachable. The backer from Sonic trades with Lucina. And that's 2-2 in this first set.
Let's do that again sometime!
It is match, but it's tournament game, potentially, for Krappus, if he's able to clutch it. Once again, Pugwest on his tournament game, and Krappus has a spongy second set, but doesn't really go with it.
Up until
game four, he seemed to have been struggling, kind of winning by the skin of his teeth, but Pug's really in control of the sets, but he's able to pull back control. It's interesting how Krappus has never seemed fully in control of all these sets yet. He's able to really still make the best of it. I think it's just Krappus' skill as a player, because Sonic does not seem to think that's the option. Krappus seems to know this pretty well. He's already got Sonic off to a pretty cool start. Interesting how the down air makes up. Just whittling the first shooter. Pugwest eats for this one. Knows he's gonna do something bad. Krappus is running out of any mix-ups to throw a Pug. If this goes to a set two, I'm not gonna be able to watch it, unfortunately. Oh, I'll be gone. Commentary's very low. I have been talking pretty quietly. I've been here for a while, so I just didn't notice my voice getting lower. But this might be better. Thanks for letting me know, Juice. I didn't know if it was providing, like, ASMR experience. Alrighty, I'm gonna try this. Angle the mic towards me. You know, sometimes you do commentary for the first time, and sometimes it works out, and sometimes it doesn't. And sometimes Pugwest is down, or Pugwest is up, or Krappus is down. Pug up, Krapp down. There, I can go. But Sonic is gonna struggle with the deficit here. He's got a lot of work to do. Able to mix up his spin dash approach options, basically pulling a Smash 4 camping with those. It's Smash 4 camping all over again with the ultimate wave dash under the ground to camp a spin dash. But Pug's having none of it. Spin dash comes out, he gets Lucina. He's really got to get this stock out. This stock is going to be the key to Krappus being able to take this game. Gotta make it happen. So he's confident in his movements now, Krappus. Takes the stock! Now if he can manage to go without getting Pug too much extra credit, that could be a great way to graft us in this set. The shield pressure from Krappus doesn't seem to be affecting Pug too much. Forward throw. You know your throw game is not very good. And you got a forward throw. Parrying the forward smash. Up throw doesn't have anything from it. Sonic's dash dancing in neutral. Maybe we'll do a game where Sonic can dash dance. Able to see through the wall of forward airs and get in one of his own. Lands a back air, just the tip of it. Oh, but Lucina! Lucina with the Dolphin Slash frame data! Pug was very happy that Krappus is now on the stock that was defined the set. And just stepping through his combo again. And again! Maybe to put some anger in Krappus, maybe just for his own personal satisfaction. Maybe just because it feels nice. I don't know how landing Dolphin Slash feels when I play this character. But I do know that Krappus is in a pretty good spot to get spring gifts, but isn't. Spring comes out in a long time. Throws an F-Smash out. A little bit weird. Pug's at the edge. And it's an F-Smash. That secures it. Pug is on his tournament stock. He's ahead, for sure. He's got an advantage in percent. He's got an advantage in momentum. If Kraftus can make this happen. Oh, the shield breaker! And that is going to be the set. Kraftus is gone, folks.
You'll never defeat me.
Damn it, I said I was gonna have to leave after this. I said I was gonna have to leave, but I'm enjoying this too much now. How can I go? This is such a good game. We're gonna update because we have had a bracket reset. We are going to see Pugwest and Kraftus play another set. On commentary right now is me, Midbus. Yes, it's me. This is like my first time on commentary. Hope I'm doing a good one. Feel free to judge in the comments. Thanks, man. Juicy Polydog. That's a nice name. Almost as nice as the four aircraft was just got on Pugwest Shield. That was the worst surprise I did. It'd be like that. Pugwest at the edge, and Kraftus is able to keep momentum, but Pugwest with a Pugwest with a side beat. Kraftus with a couple quick combos. Able to make it back to stage. But Lucina's still got advantage. Lucina's under the stage. She's gone. That is going to be a stop for Kraftus. They're too invested to leave. The sign is cool. Not going to get shield broken. Instead, going to take 30% for that unsafe shield breaker. Oh, the backwards! So smart from Kraftus. Able to use spin dash. The heavier spin dash to catch Pugwest shielding on that platform. Uses the down air to stall in midair and mix up Pugwest. But the forward smash still comes out. Not even Kraftus. I'm going to be seeing it 2-2 even stocks. But Kraftus has the advantage in percent. Forward air comes out. Kraftus has been landing those forward smash kills all game. Pugwest saw it coming. But he never saw that one coming. Now Pugwest has got Kraftus off stage. Is he going to be able to put Kraftus in a bad spot, but Kraftus is too quick. He's gone. Just waits for Kraftus' option. Pug seems just impatient. Air dodging towards stage and getting punished for it. Kraftus is pretty far up in this game. One thing I've noticed is that Pug seems to be in control of the games earlier, and it seems to just kind of be even. Both of them seem to be kind of trading it back and forth at the end of the day, which is really interesting. Hey, Pug might just be getting fatigued. He got into a... That might be the secret advantage to Sonic. The game fatigue. Because where Sonic has to make a lot of choices, Kraftus just doesn't seem to be making the bad ones. And the up air comes out. And it's pretty much an even game at this point. Stage control is big though. As Pugwest gets it. Kraftus dashing, getting the tech chase on this one though. Trying to forward smash the wrong way. He's doing so many things to Sonic. He's gonna forward smash. Stay out. But Pugwest is out for bite, not for bark. Sending Kraftus across the stage. You're with a pretty 80%. Heavy spin dash. Pug has seen his shield broken by one of those before. He's not about to let that happen again. And the movement from Kraftus! Completely nullified by Pugwest's upbeat. Kraftus is trying to space some attacks, space some tilts. The forward smash barely whiffs. Both of them are easy kill percent. Kraftus with the forward tilt. Reading the Dolphin Slash. Down smashing, but it isn't a kill! Back air will be. And that'll be game one for Kraftus. We saw this last set. Oh, I didn't update. That's my bad. This is Grand Finals losers. So both. Oh, I should probably put the both losers instead of just taking the losers off. might be a better way to do things. Be more clear. Hey, you gotta learn new things. As we go into game two, where hopefully, Pugless can learn to figure out what the hell Graphtus is doing to beat him. And Graphtus seems to be absolutely going to play patiently. And he's even taking advantage of Pugless's. With punishing Pugless for attacks that would normally be safe. Like, just a thrown forward air, you get the punish on that? Grabs him straight out of the forward smash. Pugless is a no move for games. But Graphtus is getting parried! Graphtus now just has a read on Pugless. And that is a dangerous thing. If there's one really important thing parries do, is they set a pretty confident tone of like who has an idea of what the other person's doing. Now sometimes you can tell when parries are on purpose or an action because of the way people react. And like that parry was on purpose. Pugless knew that was coming. And for that he got a stop. So in that case, him being a little impatient, a little rash, but it turned out in his favor. That was just holding the spin dash. It's those kind of plays where you need to be able to do that in Sonic. And you also need to be able to forward air Pugless in the block zone, beating the game up. A counter comes out, but Graphtus evades it. Forward smash comes out, and Graphtus is able to avoid Pugless's edge guard. Able to avoid his Pugless with the parry. Players are just at each other's heads. Both of them spot-touching each other. They were ready for each other's movements. Able to practice whiff punishing Rosina. Get up attacking, preventing the potential pressure. He's pushing into the stratosphere. Pugless can't do anything. Or Graphtus can't do anything, I should say. Oh, the homing attack. Pugless is keen to it, though. As soon as an attack is coming out, spot dodges. Reflexively, the pump. Graphtus has to get destroyed by that. Lands the combo starter, but it doesn't blink properly. Pugless ready for the smashes. Not ready for that one. Gets a footstool on Graphtus, but it doesn't have much value. Gets another forward smash. Maybe because it's stale, maybe because it's not high enough percent, it doesn't heal. There's a back air. Also still not killing, but the tip of the back air. Right there, Graphtus is going to be bringing this in. Throw it off stage, back air. Forward tilted. Forward smash hits Graphtus. Which is in the opposite way, so he's in no true threat. But the percent difference is big. Sonic wants a lead. Sonic wants to be able to force you to approach him. Just waits for it. Pretty big out. Hook's got him on the ropes. Again with the ball jumps. That's his creative use of all the resources that's available to him, which he'd be giving him the edge here. It's hard to get the edge on an actual edge, like a sword. Pugless uses to F-smash his way into a game 2 victory, keeping the set at 1-1. I think one of the things, Sonic just struggles with killing. Players are having a laugh about something. I'm gonna open the door. Just a crack. They're just kind of talking. I'm gonna see if they're talking while they play. That might be an interesting answer. No, dead serious. Dead serious when getting starts. Pugless is aware of Crafty. Graphtus is crafty. Shenanigans. Just waits out. I say it's crafty shenanigans, but it's just the things you need. It's on it. tech from Pugwest on that homing attack. Lesser Man would have been scared. Now, Sonic easily, I think, character-wise, Sonic easily has worse fatigue factor. There's gonna be a character who struggles because of fatigue between Sonic. Xena arguably has fewer options than Sonic. Hey? Oh, the commentator.
Not working out.
Are you coming in? You don't
this
want
to. I love the commentator. This has been the longest set ever. They used to play with such great stamina. They're still going.
Yeah. It's really interesting to me that Kraken seems to be sort of pulling from a trick bag where Pugwest is just able to consistently get kills from just Lucina. Lucina being Lucina. You have forward smash, you have spacing, you have shield break, and all those things together that he's using that are sitting against the kills, but Kraken is having to go out of his way to only attack with the throws and the spin attacks.
Yeah, Lucina's just a very fundamental character. Sonic in this game isn't as strong as he was before, but I think he's cooler in a sense where you have to like engage more and you have to go out of your comfort zone.
That's one of the things that Kraftis is forced to do, and he's doing a great job of it during this tournament.
Yes. Well, there goes Sonic.
He's also gone up in flames here.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like Lucina's just like a solid character overall in the world's like fundamentals and shit. Like Pog's got great fundamentals. He's been doing it for years in Smash 4, you know.
Yeah.
Big Martha main back then. He wants Martha to come back. I'd want Martha.
It's so sad to me. When you're playing Lucina, you gotta kill like 110 consistently, whereas in some other context, you just, like as Mario, you just gotta kill it 130 with an F smash.
Yeah.
Because you're building the tippers.
The tippers are so inconsistent in this game. It's crazy. But I feel like I just like Martha being a better character just because like it rewards like good spacing while Lucina just like you just kind of C-stick, you know, something.
You'd have to make pretty significant boss moves. The consistency of not needing tippers is a pretty big factor in terms of like ease of use. And ease of use is not something Sonic has the luxury of, as he goes down. Isn't game food?
The future is not written.
I wonder if Pugwest will whip out the Young Link at any point, or if he's already experimented this matchup, he might just stay with Lucina, keep the consistency up.
My guess is that a lot of the interesting things Young Link can do are projectile-based, and Sonic just kind of doesn't care about those.
Yeah, that's true. It's a different experience. Sonic, Young Link's a weird matchup. I think Young Lucina's a lot easier.
Probably.
Sure.
And so far, it's worked out for him. Pugwest has carried momentum through most of the set.
Yes.
Enough of the set, really, to be able to reset the bracket, so...
I know, that was crazy. They're still going. I'm like... I'm over here playing friendlies, and I'm like, my goodness, they're still going.
Yeah. This is able to get back. Welcome to walls, welcome to wall jumps.
I guess that's the beauty of Kalos right there.
Yeah. Honestly, I've been watching him play for so long, I didn't have any lack of confidence that he would get back from that point, because I knew he still had wall jump as a resource. He didn't even have to use that.
It's just the part that always throws me off, like I forget when I have to summon too, but like after you up it, there's always a chance to air dodge. Just in general. I mean, like as soon as I think Sonic like I put Sonic as back forward, I see Sonic up B and like oh, they're out of range, I'm gonna die, but the new air dodge mechanic in the game kinda clutch for Sonic.
Oh yeah. A lot of characters come to clutch for like Mega Man, like Yoshi. Yoshi especially, that's pretty easy.
Yes. Nice conversion from the trap to get back here.
Ooh, Spring has been struggling with craft this game, most of the game.
Yeah.
Pug is, first game, just not sure if that's like, once you get the skill on Pug's part, or just like, it's easy to see recovery.
I think it's a little bit both. Like, Pug's definitely used to it, because he's been fucking craft this for God knows how long, Smash 4 too, and he's used to avoiding those Sonic upbeats, especially back in the day when Sonic was stronger. Sonic in this game, people sleep on him. I think he's cooler now. Like he's just so much more fun.
He's way cooler in design, but I think I could say the same about a character like Zenosuit.
Yeah, exactly. They're worse, but I think it's for
the better in terms of like their human. It just would not be better.
Also shows Kraftis as well as a different character. You know, some people just played Sonic in Smash 4 just because he was like fit their playstyle, he just can't be like a top tier, but Kraftis is the best Sonic fan they want to see.
Yeah.
He's always sticking with him.
Well, in those cases, it seems to be acceptable. Cool. They could with an up throw at 190, which, that's not bad. But then, like, it's not terrible. But then, like, Practice could just, or Marquess could just, or I think he's critical on a lot of character choice, but Practice body being a new player, so.
So Practice is an extra on his character, he's going here. People would consider this matchup, like, almost, I'd say it's probably losing for Sonic, but he's making it work out here.
Making it work might need to be upgraded to make him win, because he is down 2-1, and this could be a tournament game for him.
That's very true. Well, just playing a patient game, you know, whenever you side B, it seems to be very committal in this game. It's not as nice as it was before where he could shield.
Well, one of the things I've seen Practice do a couple times is he, charges spin dash and then jumps at air dodges all over the stage, and it's slightly slower version.
I've also seen the spin shot a few times during this game. Also, like, spin it up, and, like, he slows it down like that.
But rather than,
Very clever. There's the back air.
He doesn't kill! He isn't able to kill off of that counter either, he isn't able to punish it.
Much higher percent. Savvy? No! Such a kill.
He's gonna. He might need to get bigger up though. And all that time, Puggy.
Oh, there's the spring coming in.
And all that time, Puggy's still racking up, extra credits.
And he's got kind of quite the high percentage of rage.
He might
even
get bigger.
Good tech coming in from Practice.
Good tech coming in, or.
He's gonna try to put it up, bro. He can just still swing on that, fun fact.
Oh, we saw that a couple times earlier.
Yes, DM.
Over 150.
Yeah, they're living on the edge right now, but Kravitz is just going to get that classic back throw and he's going to secure the stock.
Now he's going to want to play defensively. Really shut out Pugless options, but
he's going to want that extra credit, as we say in the commentator business.
Yes. I like that.
Escaping. This is a pretty scary situation here. We've seen him being excellent at edge guarding and ledge guarding. Cool, that's the forward air. He's been so flush throughout this series. I think
it's gonna be really tough.
He's gonna need like a nice early gimp or something. He's good at racking up damage and winning neutral. I think he's been like very good at keeping up with Pog, but I feel like just Lucina is just so much more consistent with her no options.
You can see the kind of, I think it's starting to fatigue, it's really starting to get into it for the first time in the set. Because you're seeing him, like, he's kind of exhausted the bag of tricks.
Pug's just kind of waiting for him to come in at this point.
Yeah.
React to whatever he's got.
Well, yeah, because earlier in the set, you had seen him got landing forward air into up air combo, and that was a string that he got 40% off of, but here, Pug is keen to it, and he upbees and breaks the combo.
Yeah, Stalvin Slug being very clutch move for Lucina.
Ooh, back air. Swoop under and pivot grab from Practice.
That was a good air dodge. He was trying to hold that homing attack for the game. It was smart, but unfortunately he got no reward. Forward air for Practice this time. Practice just using his excellent movement stuff to pressure Pug.
Turn it stock, spot dodge or forward smash. This might be game.
Yeah, scary here. Ooh, down air. Ooh, neutral, he's living.
He can wall jump, but it's not enough.
Not enough.
That'll be Pugwest.
Pugwest takes the tournament. He resets bracket and comes back. My goodness.
It's incredible losers run, frankly.
No, he won.